morning, boys and girls. It's Saturday the 11th of February 2017. Welcome to this morning's United Kingdom Talk, coming to you now in full colour. Look, it's worked. I have fixed the colour problem with the live camera. Yes, if you watch the recordings, you wouldn't have noticed any difference. But we've had a bit of an issue with picture jumping when I turn the colour up on the brand new camera, on the new widescreen. I look even fatter now than I used to on a normal camera. And that is saying something, isn't it? We've managed to sort it out. How did I do it? I lowered the resolution. For technical people all over the world who are fascinated by my continuing technophobe attitude towards equipment, I have managed to find a way to lower the resolution on the thing, and now I can turn the colour up and no more picture jumping. How fabulous is that? Am I looking better in colour or in black and white? Or nearly, not really black and white, but it was more of a pasty colour. Yes. Let's say hello to the early birds this morning. With us today, Shania. I was dedicating today's programme to Shania. Shania on the Isle of Wight. Dedicated this whole programme to... No, she's not dead, dear. No, but the thing is with... I know you do dedications to people that are dead usually, but Shania is very much alive and kicking. She's got many, many more years ahead of her. Hundreds and hundreds of years, because Shania is quite young. Which means she will get probably treatment from general practitioners and police, people like that, that can keep her alive for even longer than I'm going to be alive. I'm going to be here for 500 years, chatting every single day, don't worry. I wouldn't like you to be, you know, restricted by anything like that. So good morning to Shania. And then, just as I thought I'll dedicate today's show to her, she puts up a message while the countdown's going on and says, can you hang on for a quarter of an hour? We've gone out for breakfast. You know, what do you want me to do, Shania? You know, arrange my whole schedule around your social life, dear. We had a bloke in the pub last night, actually. And this is a regular occurrence. So I called the person up. I did karaoke last night. A lovely, busy night. Oh, that was nice last night. I walked in and immediately it was busy. Because what you get is... It's much, so much more busier there than it was a year ago. And a lot of office people go in. And so there's a bit of a changeover around sort of between 8 and 9.30. While they have a few drinks and then they go and some stay for a few... to sing a few songs and then another lot come in. And... quite often, as happens, you call someone, you see them sitting there, and they're sitting there waiting patiently. The nice people are the... Oh, my God, that needs an iron, doesn't it? Oh, dear. I've just realised how creased up this old shirt is today, because I wore this last night. I generally wear the same shirt as I had on the night before when I come and chat to you. Maybe if I do that, would it hide it? Not really, will it? It's very tight. Is that better? Well, should we keep it done up today? This is my impression of Rupert the Bear. This is my most unpopular jacket with customers. So that's why I've got it on today. Yes. What quite often happens, you call, so you see someone sitting there patiently, and then eventually it comes around to their turn and you call, okay, I don't know, Jamie. Okay, it's your song, Jamie. And they're nowhere to be seen. You know, they're either outside smoking, dear. Oh! You know, moving ever closer to that coffin when they light that cigarette, they're smoking outside, or they've gone to the bar and they're, oh, can you wait 5 minutes? I beg your pardon, dear. Can you wait 5 minutes? I'm just getting just having a cigarette. Just can you wait 5 minutes? You know, if I was an aeroplane waiting to take you to, for those of you with a bit of money, Sydney, for those of you who are poor, Scotland, you know, if I was waiting to, you were waiting to go there, is that what you do? You know, you're at the bar and get good. I'll have to do a sound effect here. Good morning, passengers flying to. I don't know now. I can't think of anywhere now. All those countries in the world are. Oh, that's them. Well, passengers flying to Alicante Airport. Gate A is about to close. Gate 15 is about to close. Please go to your gate now. Now, what do you think would happen if I was at the bus? Oh, hello. Yeah, can you hold it open for another couple of minutes? Yeah, I'm just getting a drink. Can you hold the gate? What do you think they would hold the gate open? No. So why should I hold my request open for that time, dear? It's outrageous. Please come immediately when you are called. Yes. It's outrageous. It really is. So that was last night, and it was a nice busy night, and a nice night was had by all. Now, I forgot where we were going with that now. I was talking about Shania. Now, what has Shania got to do with all that? Can't remember now, but never mind. It was amusing while it happened. So that's that. So nice light last night. I got in last night. Sadly, I was a bit naughty last night. I stopped at the BP garage. I went to stop there for vegetables, because I run out of vegetables. And I've got a Marks and Spencer's attached to the BP garage on the A30. So I got some vegetables, and of course, while I was in there, I just had one packet of crisps, and then I bought two and had them both when I got back here. Rather disappointed with myself. However, slightly good news, the cat had used the litter tray when I got in. At last, it's been weeks where she hasn't been using it, bless her heart. So she must have had a good turn last night, or maybe her eyesight came back for a few moments. I don't know. And she used the catch litter tray, so I didn't have any cleaning up to do last night. So I had my crisps. And then I watched a bit of that programme, Moorside. Have you been watching that? Moorside on BBC One Colour. This programme is in full colour now, look. Colour everywhere. So much colour, dear. So much colour. Moorside, which is about when those parents hid away their little girl, Shannon Matthews, wasn't it? And then they pretended that she'd been abducted or had run away or something, you know, or run away, whatever. They pretended, and they had all the TV people out there. All the neighbours were searching. And all along, and she was found guilty of this, wasn't it? All along, they had hidden her somewhere for so many days, tied up somewhere. I don't know for what reason. Would you get money for that? Is it like an insurance thing? Or do the insurance... I mean, I don't know. I don't know why they would do that. Anyway, so this programme is on last night, Moorside. Very good, I have to say. And it shows... It shows this family in their house... And the police are trying to help them. And there's one like neighbour who's a little bit of a leader and all that. And she goes out sending out leaflets and all that, trying to find this little girl. So I'm about half an hour through the first programme of that. And there's two of them. But it's very good. So you might want to watch that Moorside. So watch that and then I come to bed. And really, that was my day yesterday. Had a bit of a haircut, as you can see. I don't know. It's a little bit... Seems to be a little bit more severe than it usually is. Once again, Ronnie stole my hairdresser. I had a very nice boy and now used to cut my hairdresser. Now Ronnie's nicked him. He's nicked him from me. So I'm a bit disappointed about that. Yes, I went to the bank, got a couple of cups of tea, and we were running out of time yesterday afternoon while I was doing all this. So sadly, I had to go to Greg's the Baker's. Oh, yes, for a cheese and onion pasty and a vegetable pasty. So I did have my vegetables. I had a vegetable pasty yesterday, which I think is as good as having a plate full of vegetables, isn't it? I mean, it's a little bit pastry around the side, that's all, isn't it, eh? Eh? Let's say hello to some more people this morning who are with us early. Good morning to Wendy. Good morning, Wendy, who sent me a lovely birthday present. Look at this. Not only a lovely birthday... Oh, I've got so much here. Look, so much to show you today. Not only a lovely birthday present, but a lovely, colourful birthday card. My birthday was last Sunday, and this only arrived last Thursday because we had trouble delivering it. But look at that. Isn't that beautiful? We do like colourful things. I'm not a bland person, dear. No grey, no magnolia, no white with a hint of blue or anything like that. No, we need bright colours in our lives. My hallway is bright red, pillarbox red. Honest, look at this. Isn't that the most colourful, beautiful card ever in the history of card making? I bet that wasn't 79 pence at Asda, was it? No! Look at that, lovely. Lovely, and all pink inside. I think that's such a nice card. I must display that there for a while in front of my orchids. Look, two orchids. The poinsettia is still holding on there. It's still holding on, waiting possibly for next Christmas. So thank you for that. And she also sent me this, The Book of Chris. Yes, specially printed for me, this is. Specially printed. Look, Chris, it's a liberty... And here's the message on the front. Look, it's all written there. Look, look, look. Can you see? It's a liberty, dear. I can't believe no one has written a book about you yet. The appalling oversight has now been addressed. Here it is. Enjoy. Happy birthday, love, Wendy. And there's all sorts of stuff in here. It says, this is a story that began many years ago in an... Not that many, dear. How many years do you want me to go? You know, many years ago in an epic, hear the word there, epic. Not me saying it. It says that in the book. Look. An epic tale. Hang on a minute. An epic tale of survival played out through the ages. Oh, it has been survival. I've nearly dead quite a few times, dear. Let me think. Once with a burst appendix. Once with... Twice being knocked over by a car. Once with a bit of a nasty disease. Four times. I've nearly died four times. More than that if you include sore throats. People used to die of a sore throat, you know. Yes, they did. You get something simple, a little cut on the finger. 100 years ago, dead. Dead. I mean, you could see how badly people... If you watch that programme, Taboo. Are you watching that programme, Taboo, on Sunday nights on BBC One Colour? Or is it Saturday? No, Saturday nights on BBC One Colour. Is it Saturday? Saturday or Sunday? I can't remember. Doesn't matter anyway. Have you seen their teeth? Oh, my word. Oh, you can see that toothbrush hadn't been invented, that a toothpaste hadn't been invented at that time. Mind you, I mean, you could possibly get all of the contestants or the interviewees on the Jeremy Kyle show, couldn't you? Have you seen that lot? Black teeth, worn down, nasty teeth, people with one teeth in their heads. And they go on the television looking like that. People are not aware. People are not aware. There are a lot of programmes on the telly at the moment that are the modern equivalent of a freak show. I'm sorry, they are. Not every single person, no. But a lot of them, I would say a majority of them, when you watch Jeremy Kyle, The X Factor, so all celebrity Big Brother. It's the modern equivalent of a freak show. And the funny thing is, the people going on it don't realise that. They don't realise they are going on there and people are going to laugh and take the mick. Yes. Not like this show, of course. Nothing like this show, dear. There's nothing freakish about this programme. There really isn't. I'm just a normal, middle-aged, sad old man sitting here talking to myself. There's nothing freaky. This is perfectly... People in other countries or people in, you know, have probably picked up this show in 500 years' time. They've been searching about some sort of internet and have come across this. I am a perfect example of what people were like in the 2000s. We were all like this. Obviously, they didn't all do chat shows, but, you know... I do. We're all like I am now. That's true. That's true. It goes on this book. A tale where a cast of millions helped one person beat a set of evolutionary odds so heavily stacked against them that finally it's a miracle that the person is here at all. It's a miracle. A true, true spectacle. A miracle come true. In this triumphant human masterpiece, every supporting actor gave the performance of a lifetime, somehow succeeding in passing a unique piece of genetic code down an extraordinary hereditary line. A tour de force that on the 5th of February 1963, which is my birthday, amazingly resulted in Chris, the star of the show. Da, 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 da. And it's got loads of stuff in here. Loads of stuff in there about television programmes that were on. The number one hit, what's this, the number one hit on the day that Chris was born was Jet Harris and Tony Meehan with Diamonds. Do you know that one? No, it's not that one. It's not Diamonds Are Forever. La da 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 da. With a great Shirley Bassey. Oh, yes. There was a girl who came on the stage. Thank you very much for that, Wendy. Which I should read at my ledger, darling. I should read this at my ledger. There was a girl in the pub last night who... There were four of them, actually. Nice girls, lovely girls. Who usually sit... They've been a few times. They sit at the front. And she came on the stage and they started singing. And then she bent down and started doing up her shoelace at the beginning of the show. I had to stop the music, dear. I had to stop the music. And I said, what are you doing? Shirley Bassey doesn't come on the stage bend over and start doing her shoelaces up. And she did have a very good comeback. The girl said, well, I don't think Shirley Bassey comes on the stage with trainers. Very good. Very good. Very good. And you're quite right, my dear. She doesn't. Maybe you shouldn't do either. Please dress up if you're coming to my karaoke nights. What a liberty, dear. Walking in all sorts of... They're becoming in pyjamas soon. Just like the students who go shopping in Asda at night time in their pyjamas. Have you seen that lot? Not the fellas, the girls. The fellas have usually got on a pair of old grey tracksuit bottoms, which I can't say that. That looks bad on them. I can't. Pair of trainers and something like that. The girls are in there in their nightclothes. Pyjamas. Dropping their dead bits of skin flake all over the floor. Oh, you'd never get into Waitrose like that, girls. Not in a thousand years. Have you been to Waitrose and see how nicely people are dressed? People get ready to go to... People don't go to Waitrose. They get ready and they go to Waitrose. Yes. Not like Audi. People just go to Audi. When, oh, my God. Very bad news I came across yesterday while I was in Wokingham. Wokingham is now, they only have a Waitrose. They had nothing else and they haven't had anything else there for ages. They have a couple of little corner shops, you know, but only a Waitrose and a Marks and Spencers. Can you believe the place? I don't know if I can even tell you this. Can you believe that the place is having a bit of a refit at the moment, you know, building new shops and that. And Audi is going into the area. An Audi is going into the area of Wokingham. I cannot believe it. Can you just imagine the short sort of people that are going to be moving down there soon? That is going to attract into that beautiful area. So if you ever want to go to Wokingham, go soon. Go soon because you won't want to go there once Audi have moved in, dear. You really won't. It's got so nice at the moment. I can just see it in my head now how it's just all falling apart in Wokingham. Oh, they'll even have to lock the church up at the weekends. Terrible, terrible. We haven't said hello to these people yet. I'm sorry. Good morning to Kevin Webster. Anyone got a cold? Well, I've been sneezing quite well today, Kevin, this morning. Now, I've noticed something. The sneezing stops shortly after I leave the house. So it's something in that. It's actually not just in this room, to be fair. And my little bit of asthma and all that generally disappears as soon as I leave the house. So there's something in the house. It might be something to do with the cat. I don't know. You know, there's something in the house that makes me sneeze and cough and splutter. So, yes, but I don't think I've got a cold, Kevin. Have you got a cold, Kevin? Oh, what a shame, dear. Hot water bottle. That's what you need sitting on your lap while you're watching this. All right. Good morning to Wayne. Good morning, Wayne. DJing tonight somewhere, aren't you, lovey? DJing in, possibly down in Kent. He travels quite far away. Though. Good morning to Peter Hides. Good morning, Peter. Terry H is with us. Good morning, Terry. It's been a while since we got a little message from you, dear. Have you fallen out of love, lovey? Is it me, dear? Is it me? And good news for Terry H fans. Terry H works for British Gas, who have held their prices at least until August. Congratulations. There's a load of them put their prices up. N-Power, the Scottish one. Is it SSE? SSE, I think they've put their prices up. British Gas are holding their prices down. And if you've never done it before, you need to go on one of those price comparison websites. Uswitch or something like that. You should be doing that every single year as your contract comes to an end. You get nothing in this day anymore for loyalty. Absolutely not. And that goes with everything. I've said this so many times before. Switching your gas and electricity, you could possibly be doing it. Switching every year. It's not that hard. It looks hard to start with. Once you've done it once, it's easy. You just type in a few numbers, tell them how much gas you're using. If you don't know, it should be on your bill somewhere. If you don't know that, you just type in how much you're paying per month or something like that. And you go with the cheapest one. Honestly, it's no different buying electricity from N-Power or British Gas. It's all the same. Mine, I get mine from a company called G-Energy, G-N-E-R-G-Y. They were cheapest at the time. Now, my contract will be up in April, I think, something like that, April. And I'll be going straight back on there and searching again to see if I can find a better deal. So never, ever stick with anything. Car insurance especially and household insurance. Oh, my Lord. Never stay with the same one for more than a year. Never. I change almost every year. I think this year I'm with the same one, so it's 2 years in a row. But even if you don't want to switch, right, do the comparison, and you can do it all in the internet, compare all the insurances from everyone else, and then once you've got your figure, you can ring up your current insurer and say, well, I found, you know, a price that's £100 cheaper. Can you match that? And generally they will. And it's funny. It's funny, right? This has happened to me a couple of times as well. So you're with one insurer. Let's take an example. AXA Insurance. AXA, right? You're with them. And then you do a price and that you get your renewal price, say £500. £500, right? And then you go on the internet and you do a price comparison thing and they say, how much you pay? And you say £500. And then you can come back with the next cheapest one at the same company, AXA. Yeah, that can happen. And what you have to do then is sign up for a new account with, you can't, they won't match the price of their own one. You have to re-sign up with them. Oh, it's mad. Mad. You get absolutely nothing for loyalty to any of these companies anymore. Gas, electric, car insurance, household insurance, broadband. Every year I ring up Virgin Media and I say, no, it's too dear. I don't want to pay this anymore. And they say, well, that's what the price is. OK, cut me off. OK, we'll put you through to disconnections and they do you some sort of deal. Never, ever assume, well, you're not. Never, ever think that you're getting better value for loyalty, because that doesn't exist anymore. Not since the bloody money men took everything over. All right, remember that. Good morning to John Child. Good morning, John. I hope you're enjoying your gift that was bought in for you last night. Two songs from John last night. Well done, John. Two songs last night. Or did you do three? I think you did three last night, didn't you? We're a little bit short of singers last night. We weren't short of customers, just short of singers last night. When I say short of singers, there were still 16 singers, which is quite a lot. But it wasn't like 25 as there has been some Fridays. So thank you, John. Good morning to Tim. Good morning. Who says, Chris, how are you this fine, chilly morning? Very pleased to not have gone out yet. Although I'm going to have to go out a little bit later. I need to go to the post office. I've got something here for Joanna, one of our regular viewers, that I still haven't managed to get down to the post office yet. Warren says, shame you've got the wrong date on the calendar. What, the 11th? It is the 11th, dear. 11th. It says up there. Warren, are you able to... I know, you're a radio man, aren't you, Warren? Sorry, darling, you are a radio man, not a television man, dear. Do pay full attention. Where is the wrong date? Did I say the wrong date? Did I say the 11th of February? I'm sure I didn't, Warren. I'm sure I didn't say that, dear. It says the 11th of February, Saturday. It's all up there. Do pay full attention, Warren. Very disappointed, didn't you? Very, very disappointed, dear. Good morning. Terry H says, where's the mugs? I'd love one. Okay. Send me your address, Terry. One is on its way to you almost as we speak. I might have to wait till Monday. It depends how long I'm sitting here chatting to you today. Terry, send me your address, okay? Now, what's upside down? What is upside down? Is there something upside down? There's nothing upside down, is there? What are you going on about? I didn't notice the crease in his shirt until I mentioned, oh, this is really awful, this shirt today. It's linen. Linen is a nightmare. You just move it to the side one moment and all the creases appear suddenly, yes. You iron? I don't think so. No, I don't iron much, sis. I have a lady do my ironing. Yeah, she's not very expensive either. So it generally works out at less than £1 a shirt. You take it down to dry cleaners and Mrs. Patel, who runs the dry cleaners just down the road there, she does ironing, but it's like £2.50 an item, dear. God's sake, man. She's a bit dear. But she has got a very nice boy who works in there, I must say. I like to go and watch him sometimes, yes. Warren says, look at you thinking you're Steve Allen. I don't think I'm Steve. You're having a laugh, aren't you? I don't think I'm Steve Allen, dear. Why would I think that? That man is at the top of the tree. He's like my top talk show host. Top talk show host, Steve Allen. Top DJ, Tony Blackburn. I could never, ever be like them, dear. I'm just a sad little old man sitting in his spare room chatting away to you. That's me, Warren. I know my place, dear. I know my place. Have you pressed the button for the calls? Thank you, Shania. No, I haven't. Button has now been pushed. There is a phone line open if you'd like to call in this morning. It's 020-8144-3477, okay? 020-8144-3477. We have a Skype in as well. The Skype in number is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Skype in United Kingdom Talk. Phone number 020-8144-3477. If you can't remember what I just said, just go to the top of the post and I think you'll find the phone number up there, darling. All right. Good morning to Jason Alexander, who says, is that two family bags of crisps? No, Jason. Two grab size bags. Yeah, I had a bag of salt and vinegar discos. I quite like those. They're very strong, aren't they? Those salt and vinegar disco crisps. I had a grab size bag of those and a grab size bag of Walker's cheese and onion crisps. Now that is quite, that is like 100 grams of crisps just before I went to bed last night. Terrible. Terrible. But they didn't affect my sleeping too badly. Jason, I don't know if you was with us on Thursday or Friday's show. I can't remember when was that. But on the way home from the quiz night, I stopped at Five Guys and I had this like mushroom burger thing, some spicy chips, a vanilla shake and two lots of Coca-Cola, and then went to bed 2 hours later. No, it's kept me up all night, that did. Oh, and I could feel it on my gut, you know. It's a good job. I've got a John Lewis feather down mattress topper because I was able to roll over and you're, like, your stomach then makes an indent in there, but I could still feel it pushing against the rest of my organs. My organs were becoming crushed. They really were. I have to watch out for my organs. I really do. Good morning. Who's calling in now on line 4763? Oh, no, we've lost them. Never mind. Do you want to try that again? I think you might have put the phone down accidentally then. Accidentally put the phone down. Call in again, OK? 020-8144-3477. Good morning to Joey, who's with us this morning. Joey has received his gift as well. Adam's with us today. Adam, good morning. Adam the plumber, who turned up at the karaoke last night. Good morning, Adam. Hello, who's calling in?
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, stop using my Wi-Fi.
Who's using your Wi-Fi?
You've been using my Wi-Fi. I looked up your IP address and found your phone number.
You looked up my what?
Then why did your search history appear when I signed in? Explain that.
Why did I search what?
How did you even get my password?
I haven't got your password. Why would I want your password?
I'm not arguing with you. Just stop or I'm getting the police involved.
I bet you've got a really rubbish Wi-Fi anyway. I bet you've got a really rubbish Wi-Fi. Why would I want to use your rubbish Wi-Fi?
Why don't you just set up your own Wi-Fi?
I don't need to set up my own Wi-Fi. If you've got one, I can just use yours.
I pay for that with my hard-earned money.
Oh, please.
Get a job.
Please. Someone sounding like you probably hasn't got a job. I bet you got up about 3 minutes ago. You lay in bed most of the day playing computer games. I bet you've never worked in your life, have you?
You are a bandwidth thief.
I am
a
bandwidth.
You're the reason the economy is failing.
Why pay when I can steal it from someone else?
You are Wi-Fi stealing scum.
I am Wi-Fi stealing scum. Yes, that is correct. Is that it? I wonder who that was. Wi-Fi. I don't think I need your Wi-Fi, darling. I'm on the Virgin mega speeds of 200 meg here, dear. We're firing across the whole of the world at rapid speed. I don't need your Wi-Fi. What are you on? Something like Sky? A pathetic, paltry 74 meg, dear. Don't make me laugh. Please. Virgin, dear. Virgin 200 meg. Thank you. If you want to get technical, but and in full colour as well. We are coming to you in full colour. Yes. In colour. Full colour, 200 meg. Thank you very much. Yes, good morning to Adam, who was at the karaoke last night. Now, Adam has now lost, well, it'd be even more weight that he's lost. He's lost 1 stone and 6 pounds in the space of a month. And he is a member of Slimming World. And Adam at the moment is bringing me in various different chocolate bars. I've now got 4 boxes of these bloody things. Various different chocolate bars to test for you on the air. Today we have chocolate orange, cherish me, and he's also given me romance me, Rocky Road, and devour me, oh, double chocolate crisp. Well, I've already got one of those, Adam. One minute. It's over here, isn't it? The double chocolate crisp. I've already got one. Oh, I've got two of these now, Adam. Look, he keeps bringing me in these gifts, aren't you naughty dear? Thank you very much. Now, I'm not going to sample some on today's show because I don't have a cup of tea with me. I do notice, actually, sometimes I like to bring up a cup of tea with me. By the time I get to it, by the time I finish chatting, it's absolutely stone cold. I don't like cold tea. My dad used to love cold tea. Do you like cold tea? Oh, and here's something else you don't ever want to have cold. You don't want to have warm. A McDonald's milkshake. Buy one, have half of it and let the other bit go room temperature and then have it. Oh, it is disgusting. It is disgusting. We do like a proper milkshake, though, we do. So I've got these to try. I'm quite liking the look of this one, the Rocky Road one. So these are little chocolate bars from, as I say, from Slimmer's World. And they've got, how many calories in one of these? One moment, please. Just a moment, dear. where are we? 306 calories. Oh, no. 73 calories. Rocky Road. Oh, it's got little bits of... look at this. A sumptuous cereal bar with honeycomb, raspberries and marshmallows dipped and drizzled in smooth milk chocolate. And they're only 73 calories each. So I've got to get onto those. And I should have come in last night and had one of these, as Adam suggested. But no, I don't think I would have stopped at the BP garage and bought crisps had I not have needed vegetables. And talking of Adam, he's on the line. Good morning, Adam the Plumber.
Good morning, Chris Redd, an international DJ and award winner of the Boys Award 2005, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17.
Hooray! Thank you very much. Award-winning Chris Redden speaking to you live from the Mirrable Studios at the moment. Are you working today, Adam?
I'm not. I'm with my my surrogate sister from the Isle of Wight.
You're with your who?
Hello, Chris!
Who is it?
Sam from the Isle of Wight.
Hello, Sam. Oh, I know people on the Isle of Wight. A very good friend of mine, Shania and Vectis. Shania, who's having the whole program dedicated to Shania today.
I know James and Judith that work at Vectis with Shania.
Do you?
They're good friends of mine. So, how are you, darling? It's lovely to hear your dulcet tones.
Where is it she works?
At Vectis. Judith and James
Bow. A vet, did you say?
Yeah, Vectis Radio.
Oh, Vectis Radio. Sorry, darling. Yes, of course. Right. And they're on there as well, are they?
Yeah, they're there.
I'm hoping to visit Vectis Radio at some point this year on my grand tour of the United Kingdom, yes.
Ooh, fabulous.
Oh, that's better. We'll have you picked up the phone or something?
We'll have to come and see you, darling.
Yes. What, have you just picked up the phone or something?
Chris?
What?
That's all right, we lost you there for a second.
What are you doing with that phone?
We don't know what we're doing.
Are you able to use a telephone, dear? You pick it up and put... I know what it is. You're on bloody hands-free, aren't you?
Yeah.
Oh, well, turn it off hands-free and pick the damn thing up, dear. Oh, how many times do I have to give people instructions on how to use a telephone?
Well, I'm trying to do a multi-bilingual call unless Sam phones in on your other line and we merge the calls.
Merge the calls? I can do
that. But that's complicated.
Well, how many people do we want on the phone at the same time, Adam? That's the question.
This is true. Anyway, let me hand you back to Sam and she can carry on the conversation.
Just before you go, I'm liking the look of the Rocky Road one. I'm very much like, look at all these chocolate things.
Try Rocky Road live on air.
So these, I won't do it now because I haven't got a cup of tea here. There's one, two, three, four. There's six in a box. This is going to last me for ages, isn't it? See, I think, Adam, you can come unstuck, though, if you have one. Oh, I just have another one. Do you see what I mean?
Well, that's it. You know, you've got to control, dear. Control is the key.
I've got no self-control at all, have I? I'm really terrible.
I'll have to come around and tie you up if you don't.
Oh, no, I'm not into anything like that, dear. Oh, no. I mean, I don't mind having a cup of tea with you, but we're not doing anything like that, dear. No.
And just slowly feed you little bits of the bar at the time, you know.
I don't want to end up. Don't want to end up like one of those MPs that was found with an orange in his mouth. Do you remember that one years ago?
Cynthia Payne, wasn't it? Love that film. Absolutely love that film. My favourite film in the world.
What, the
Personal Services.
That's hilarious, isn't it?
Oh, I love it. I love it.
I love the bit at the end where she goes in and there's the judges sitting there and all that.
That's it. Yeah, it's a fantastic film. Absolutely fantastic. Like the film Bride.
What are you doing today then? You're just out with your friend, are you?
Well, yeah, I'm out with Sam. We're going to IKEA.
Oh, yes. What you're buying in there?
To look at some new kitchens for her.
Oh, you're putting in
there? Being international that she is from the Isle of Wight.
Yes.
She is the international diva of the Isle of Wight. If you ask anybody on the Isle of Wight and say, do you know the diva of the Isle of Wight? They all go, yes.
Did she bring you any duty frees over?
Did you bring any duty frees over, dear? No, she didn't. Just herself and her voice.
How rude. I'm going to have to undo my jacket. And you'll have just have to put up with the creased shirt, which is a bit tight on me, actually. It wasn't tight like this at Christmas. Oh, dear, I don't know what I'm going to do, Adam, dear. It's so hard to walk past those crisps, isn't it?
And my bag of shopping from Aldi.
Oh, and her bag of shopping from Aldi, because she is an Aldi shopper.
Oh.
Oh.
Well, I think we'll leave it there, then. Thank you very much for the call.
Yes, I heard you.
Bye-bye.
Aldi's
happening. I'm sorry, I can't have Aldi shoppers ringing into this programme, dear.
Are you still there? Have you cut me off, dear?
I'm going to have to go, dear. We can't have Aldi shoppers on here. I'm sorry, Adam.
Hold on. I'll just get Sam to demonstrate her trade to you. Bear with me.
Okay.
There you go, dear. International singer diva from the Isle of Wight.
Have you ever thought of coming to one of my karaoke nights, Sam?
Can you come down to one of your karaoke nights?
Well, please don't.
I can't afford me, darling.
I can't afford you. No, not
very
not
expensive,
the way
dear. Very expensive DJ.
She is. She is very expensive. But
I won't get paid in packets.
She won't get paid in packets.
I don't understand that, Aldi. You know, you're going doing your shopping. You pull out some tomato sauce, and you pull out a packet of biscuits, and then there's electric drills. It just doesn't make sense in there. And then you go a bit further, slippers. And then there's the cheese, and then there's the milk, and then boxes of screws. I don't understand Aldi at all. It's very strange.
It's the perfect store for you, Chris. I mean, you could be putting your fluffy slippers on while screwing a shelf up in the Mirrorball Studios to display all your new items with your lovely new camera.
Well, I suppose so, dear. It's all working now, isn't it? I'm very pleased. I'm very pleased with having succeeded with my technical issue. I'm very pleased about that.
Indeed, indeed, dear. Well, I shall let you get back to your wonderful show, and we look forward to watching the rest of the show.
Thank you. She's not in her pyjamas, is she?
No, you're not in your pyjamas, are you, dear? No, she's in a little black number this morning.
Did she come across on a hovercraft?
Did you come across on the hovercraft?
No.
No,
I came on the car ferry, but I passed it off as an
aspirant. Is that another language? Are we speaking in another language, dear?
No, she did. She did. She's being rude.
What did she say?
Repeat it.
I said I came on the car ferry, but I managed to pass it off as an asthma attack.
Thank you. Goodbye. Well, we'll move on very swiftly from that rude comment on this programme. Thank you, Adam. So we said hi to Sam on the Isle of Wight. Wendy says, show them the MRI brain scan. I haven't had a brain scan. I hope I don't need one of those, Wendy, do I? Aaron says I should try cleaning. I tell you what, Aaron, you want to see the state of my bathroom at the moment? Oh, it's awful. I haven't done it for weeks. And you know when you brush your teeth, there's all like little splashes of toothpaste all over the wall. And over the sort of, you know, the bathroom area. I need to have that. I need to clean that when I finish the show today. I'll tell you that. Good morning. Who's calling in from wherever you are?
Oi.
Good morning.
Oi, what's wrong with Aldi shoppers then?
Oh, no, you're not going in there as well. Is that Vectis?
It is, yeah.
Good morning, Vectis, from Vectis Radio International.
I've just come back from Aldi. I've just got my Uber taxi that, by the way, was a Toyota Prius.
What is wrong with people?
Filled the boot up. Well, they haven't got a very good big boot because they're just... full up with lead acid batteries that are bad for the environment as well. But yeah, I've just got my Uber taxi back from Aldi and I'm just putting it all away in the larder.
Uber on the Isle of Wight?
Hey?
You have Uber on the Isle of Wight?
No, we don't actually. I'll tell you something that'll make you laugh actually.
Well, go and try.
Last Friday, not yesterday, but the Friday before, because I'm a bit, like you are as well, dear, a bit of a radio nerd. Radio Solent, which is our local radio station for sort of the Isle of Wight and the South Coast. You know what it is. It's quite a big region, isn't it, what the BBC cover.
Yeah.
But it's our local radio thing.
Is it BBC Radio Solent? Is it that one? Is it BBC Radio Solent?
That's right, yeah.
Well, you just said it was Radio Solent. Could have been anything. Could have been one of the Bayer Group. Did you see the Did you see the thing that came around from the Bayer Group?
Yeah, funny, wasn't it?
Have you seen, I'll get that up, ready to read out to people. Anyway, carry on.
Yes. So, the guy
sorry.
That does this...
So it's happening. Sorry.
You want to get tablets, all right?
It's okay. I'm all right now. I'm back with you in the room. Continue.
Right. So I've lost my thread now. Oh, that's right. No, so this BBC Radio Solent, the guy who does the breakfast show there has been doing it for 20 years, believe it or not.
Right.
So as just to mark the occasion... his show was live from the Mayflower Theatre in Southampton.
Oh,
which
yes.
Which, as it happens, is only like 3 minutes away from their studios. But anyway, his show normally starts at 6:30, but on this particular occasion it started at 7:00. So I went over to have a nose. As you can imagine, that's quite a difficult thing from the Isle of Wight, trying to get a ferry to get
you
there.
You went to the BBC, dear?
BBC, yes.
You went to BBC Solent. How did you manage to get in there, dear?
Well, it wasn't because they he was doing his show live in front of a live audience at the Mayflower.
Okay, yes. Sorry, I wasn't listening properly then. Continue.
Oh, look, if I take the time and trouble and it's...
Oh, come on, get on with it,
all
dear.
All the way from the Isle of Wight.
We're not on air for hours. Get on with it, for Christ's sake.
Right, I've lost my thread again now. Oh, that's right. So anyway, I have lost my thread, actually, where I was going with that.
Right, you were going to see radio's BBC Radio Solent on the other one.
This was about Uber as well. Yeah, I'll just
Uber.
Get to that in about
Uber.
Hours. Yeah, so I went and saw the show going out live, and it was quite interesting, because really, the BBC, for all that huge amount of money they take out of us for radio on our TV licence, they don't do a lot different, actually, to what we do at Vectis Radio at our... outside broadcast. They're sort of linked to the studio through a computer, and even though they were there at the theatre, they could access all of it and what have you. So yeah, well, that was quite interesting to see how the other half did. But what I was going to say, you'll find this really funny, was on the way over on the ferry, I had to get the car ferry. I was as a foot passenger because it was so early in the morning, and I thought, I know, I'll book myself an Uber taxi on my super duper Uber app that I've got on the telephone.
Uber app, yes.
The app. So it's all quite clever now, because you can actually even ask for a certain pickup time. So that was all right. So on the hour crossing, it is on the Red Funnel car ferry. I'd done that. So I jumped off the ferry, expecting my Uber taxi to arrive, and there wasn't any available. I don't think there's anyone there. Just sat there scanning and scanning. So I had to do it the old-fashioned way and run up the pier. Well, run. I had to slow walk up the pier. And get a conventional taxi. So there you go. That's one in the eye for Uber.
Oh, you want to be a little bit careful like that, looking like you do standing around on street corners. You know, you find police cars suddenly pull up and start, oh, hello, sir, whereabouts are you going today? Because yeah, you do look like a bit of a criminal, to be honest.
I think it's a dirty grey Mac that does it. But
well,
I really
no, must, I wasn't going to say no. More of a burglar. You come across as someone that might try and get through someone's window and possibly get stuck at the same time as well, dear.
Burgers? Are you talking about burgers?
No, burglars.
Oh, sorry.
Burglars. You
talking
say
of
that.
Burgers?
When you were saying that about the BBC like connecting to all these other places, Nigel Farage has been doing this show on LBC from Brussels. I'm sorry, I swear they're using Skype. Because the quality is not good. It actually sounds like they're doing it over Skype. And they've got, you know those little plastic microphones you used to get free with a computer?
Yeah.
I swear he's using one of those. The quality is really bad.
And you know, it's on the BBC television news, whenever they go to Tel Aviv or anything like that. That's always Skype now, because the picture and the sound quality is terrible.
Yeah, I've noticed that. I think
What happened to the BBC being this worldwide organisation that had these little 6-foot by 3-foot booths in every city in the world?
They're saving money. They're saving money. And when you say that, you know, when you say that you go and see the bit and they got all this stuff there and they're just basically doing it. You can't be any much closer to the truth than that. Because,
If obviously it was an outside broadcast and they wanted it to sort of go well, but it's the amount of people, Chris. You
I know.
It. There was a presenter. He had someone by the side of him that is his producer that's helping him with all the technical equipment. That's a laugh. When he goes wrong at Vectis Radio, you just hit it and hope for the best.
And do
anyway,
it. Same as I do. I'm sitting here.
They had a woman there. They had a guy there doing the sport. They had a woman doing the weather. What else did they have? They had someone else doing the travel, and all this for one show and about four
and you
or
do
five
it all.
Young girls running around.
You do the old thing. I'm sitting here. There's a little webcam in front. I mean, it doesn't look perfect. It's not like perfect television, but there's a webcam in front of me taking out a live show.
Yeah,
there's an iPhone recording me. There's an iPhone recording me for the recording, and it goes out from the internet. A couple of TV computer monitors in front of me goes out on the internet. Don't look much different to the television, does it?
No, it tends to make your cheeks look a bit flabby, I think. But other than that, it's okay.
What do you mean, flabby cheeks?
Flabby cheeks.
I've got flabby cheeks.
It's all that vegetarian rubbish you eat. You want to get back to burgers, mate. They do a lot.
I think the vegetarian diet I'm having is making me get fat.
Oh, it is.
That is definitely what's going on. You're absolutely right.
Mind you, talking about burgers, this will give you something that's really sad. When I was over in Southampton, so I actually done a bit of shopping, so I needed some knickers and socks, as you do. You've got to get
knickers? Oh, my God, you're not starting to do the old women's clothes wearing, are you?
Oh, my Lord. Oh, dear.
What is going on in your life, Vectis?
But anyway, what I was saying was, on my way back, before I caught the ferry, I had to go into McDonald's and get two... Shania's just corrected. I had to go into Burger King, because we haven't got a Burger King on the island, and get two, bacon XL burgers. And I took them back, and they didn't have them cold. I warmed them up. But how sad is that?
Well, there's nothing sad about that. You don't want them cold, shove them in a microwave, warm them up a bit. What's the sadder thing about it is the poor little pigs that have died. That's what's sad, lovey. The poor pigs and the cows that have been dragged out with hooks in them. Oh, it's awful.
They'd only be bored, wouldn't they?
You must move over to mushrooms and carrots, lovey. You really must.
Oh, no, they call me mushroom at work, so I'm kept in the dark and I don't know much. And I'm also a fun guy. A fun guy.
I like it, yeah. Why don't you do stand-up comedy?
I should be on the radio, shouldn't I?
You should be on the radio. On Vectis Radio. When are you on? Oh, are you on today?
Tomorrow. I've got some exciting news, actually.
Oh, yes.
When you come over in the summer, if it's anywhere in which I expect it... Oh, I don't know. I don't know when you're gracing us with your presence. But if it's anywhere after April, possibly June...
Yes.
And you pop in to see me while I'm doing my show, you will be a FM radio DJ.
Have you got a? Is that a permanent license or an RSL?
No, it's a permanent license. We've managed to fund the money. That was the great sort of like concern about it, because we need to find £10,000 to go on FM. But we found the money by hook or by crook.
Did you have a big investor at all or contributor?
I don't quite know the ins and outs of the finances, but I think someone's. I think it's a loan. I'm not sure. But we've raised about three, four grand off our own back, which is pretty good for a little station. So, yes, we can contact Ofcom now and say we definitely want the licence. And it's only going to be within about 5 kilometres of Newport.
Excellent.
Because it's like a community licence.
Yes,
it's quite
yes,
a low-powered licence.
Is someone going out trying to get adverts and all that?
Yeah, well, we run with adverts now. The community sort of taken us under our wing, and we get quite a few sort of adverts. But it's a bit like what we were saying about Radio Solent, actually. Although I know, obviously, they're BBC and they don't need adverts. But we've got one person, bless him, who sort of sells for us.
Yeah.
And so it's all a bit sort of hand to mouth. But yeah, at least we've definitely got it now. So I think in about six weeks' time, we'll be given our frequency, and then we can really get things going.
Excellent.
I didn't realise until I talked to our technical guy that evidently you can't sort your aerial out. Evidently, you know your frequency, because evidently the aerial is built to the exact frequency.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's like a pole when they cut a bit off, then that makes the frequency. I knew years and years ago. I had a little pirate radio station.
You did. You
I did. Boy. That would have been 1980. Gosh. 1981, maybe 82, something like that. At a pirate radio station, this mate, my mate built me a transmitter, which was about the size of two cigarette boxes. It was connected.
And you used to work for the GPO.
Yes, it was connected to a car battery, and the aerial. We had to choose a. Well, it was quite easy in those days, you know, because there was so much empty frequency space. You chose your frequency, and then there would be he looked it up, and you'd have instructions on how long that the aerial was in two parts. There was a wooden bit in the middle, yeah, like a dowel, like a wooden dowel, and he would slide over a bit of metal at the top and a bit of metal at the bottom. They were both the same size, and he would have to cut them to the correct size, to the correct length for the frequency. So, yes, I understand that, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, all technical stuff.
I was no good at making anything like that. I did try once to make an intercom.
Right.
There was no soldering involved. It was a wired intercom. Mm. And you got all the parts, you know, like a boy's Christmas present, I think it was. You got all the points and you had to screw them down. I couldn't get the damn thing working. Could I send it away and it came back working? You know, you could send it away if you couldn't get it working, and someone would look at it and they'd find out what was wrong. But I can't get electronic things working.
You know, the thing that surprised me, because we had a bit of a staff meeting on Tuesday, and Schneider, how much did they say the transmitter was, Shax? Can you remember? Can't remember, can you? Yeah, but the thing that surprised me the most anyway was if you want an RDS encoder, which is basically the thing that if you're in the car...
The words,
and you,
yes.
Yeah, and you click on not Vectis radio, it then mean it will come up on your display as Vectis radio, but that doesn't happen by magic. You need a special bit of kit. And that's $2,500.
Oh, yeah, that stuff is quite dear.
Just to be able to put your...
just put the name on.
...radio playing the best hits on the island.
Oh,
you know,
you're going to the wrong place, dear. Try eBay. There's loads of that stuff on eBay.
Oh, right, I'll have to
hang on
that
a minute. I'm going to look. Hang on. eBay. One moment, please. eBay. Let's have a look. RDS encoder, innit?
Yeah.
Is that it? RDS encoder.
Yeah, that's the one.
There it is. Hang on a minute. RDS encoder. Now, here's a proper one.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that looks like a proper... There's a lot of, like, things that look like kit ones. You don't want a kit one. You want a box, don't you?
Yeah.
Right, there seems to be one here. Ah, now, that's in America.
Yeah, right.
So you'd have to have it sent over from America, but £360.
Oh, right. No,
and that looks proper. I'm going to put that on your wall.
Yeah.
Now, you know, that being said, if you was to buy it and it didn't work, don't come back to me and said you said you should buy this. Hang on a minute. Vectis. Where are you, Vectis?
Yeah, so I'll mention that. I never thought of that, but I'll mention that to our tech guy and see what he thinks.
It's worth having a look around on places like that. Does it have to be new? No, it doesn't have to be new, does it?
No, I wouldn't have thought so. No,
eBay, is that .co.uk? See, there's a lot of kit ones there.
Yeah, mind you, our tech guy might be happy enough with that.
Now, what's this? There's a Kenwood external media controller. It doesn't look like the right thing. Ah, there's one. Panasonic radio data system, RDS encoder, £801.
Yeah, right.
So I would have a look on there if I were you.
Yeah, because we've run Rectus Radio for 7 years, and our playout computer and the stuff that streams it, and the stuff that runs Facebook, we've never, ever, ever had a brand new computer, believe it or not. In actual fact, up until just before Christmas, we've had the same computer that's run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for 7 years.
Does it work?
Well, it doesn't now, but it did do up until before Christmas. So it just goes to prove you don't need new stuff, do you?
No, not always. I don't think so. You know, I was running on that that other iPhone for ages, wasn't I?
Yeah. It's but still, as I say, it's everyone, all the team at Vectis Radio, because I know Judith and I forget his name, Judith and James, who Adam's sister was talking about. I know them quite well.
Well, I think I'll have to come and do a little show for you while I'm there. How's that? There's an offer you can't refuse.
That's right. You know, I might be able to give you your break in radio. This time next year, you might be on Radio 2. You never know.
88. Well, there's no room now. They got rid of all the nighttime people. Alex Lester. They got rid of Alex Lester. He's been on there for years.
Yeah, he used to be the truck driver's favourite, Alex Lester.
Very entertaining man. Got rid of all the night staff. Can't believe it.
No, you know, it's amazing, isn't it? It's good. Because the one thing that I hate, and of course at Vectis Radio, we do, I'm not the programme director, but at Vectis Radio...
Oh, you will be soon.
But I really hate recorded programmes. You know, I don't know. But perhaps I probably am, because I'm a radio nerd. It's probably like you. If you listen, you can tell, can't you? You can tell
whether
something's recorded or not.
Do you collect jingles?
Sorry?
Do you collect jingles?
No, not
you do, but... don't you? I bet you collect jingles. I've got some lovely jingles here, dear, from when I was on Liberty Radio in London. Oh, they were good, they were. Liberty Radio jingles.
I don't know who does our jingles, actually. They're very sort of professional sounding.
Are they musical ones, or are they just like talk? I don't like talk over ones, they're boring.
No, we have musical ones as well.
Yeah. So you saw that list from the Bayer Radio Network, did you? Bayer City Radio? Did you see that? Look at this. This is instructions.
The funniest thing I thought about it, Chris, was what was it? The power links are only supposed to last 15 seconds.
Power links.
Yeah,
what is a power? It's all crap. It's
I shared that to my Facebook page.
Yeah.
And I put on there 15 seconds you're laughing and got all sorts of abuse.
I know. Well, I'm going to read this out to our millions of viewers now, okay, Vectis?
Right. Yeah.
No, nice of you to call in. Have a lovely day,
okay.
All right?
And love to Shania. Have a good weekend.
Bye-bye now. Cheerio. There we are. Our lovely Vectis. He does some radio on the Isle of Wight there. Let me just so I know. Vectis, Isle of Widget. Isn't he Widget? There we are. That's saved into the system. Yes, there's a company called Bauer City. Now, they own radio stations all up and down the country. Now, when I was, and I've spoken about this a few times, when I was in my 20s, you would listen to radio and it would be entertaining. People like Tony Blackburn, Dave Lee Travis, all this, and they would entertain you. But I very much doubt that they had a set of instructions sitting there in front of them, telling them basically when to talk and how to do it. Because this company, Bauer City, has sent this out to their presenters. Look, BC1 style guide, that means Bauer City 1 style guide, presenter specifics. So some bod has been sitting in an office and worked all this out. Are you ready for this? Every link. Now, a link is the bit that is spoken between records or adverts or before the news or anything like that. Look, every link, say, all the biggest hits all day long in every link. I mean, how boring is that to start with? That's only the first thing. All the biggest hits all day long. And also say the station name in every link. So, you know, every time virtually every sentence I would speak, I would have to finish with all the biggest hits all day long. You're listening to United Kingdom Talk. And you'd soon get bored with that, surely. New music links, speed links, crunch and roll. Right, this is all on the instructions to the Bauer City presenters. Always say all the biggest hits all day long in the top of the link, never the end. Say the station name into the new song. These links should be 10 to 15 seconds maximum and only focus on selling the song coming up, nothing else. Every time that you play a B or C list song, it's new to someone listening to your show. Sell it to that person each time. If you think you've heard it a lot, the audience are just getting to know it. Links into breaks or junctions. Again, always say all the biggest hits all day long at the top of the link, never the end. We don't want people associating our position with commercials. Tease into every break. Now, a tease is when you're kind of giving them a tease of what's coming up next. Okay, so, I mean, I could say, well, we're going to be talking about gardening next. That's a tease. That's a tease. Your teases need to be signed off by your content controller or content director, brackets, breakfast producer, breakfast teams, prior to your show. You've got to write all this crap down first. And if that's not, then it has to go to someone else to be checked before you say it. Can you imagine me doing something like that? I don't think so. I don't think so. Your teases tease me. Don't warn me. Never tell me the song and artist. The thought of that particular song may prompt me to switch out. They have already, mate. Don't you get it? They have already switched out. I would be. I'm not a radio. I'm not really a radio person, am I? I am a listener. And if I don't like this, you should be listening to me, not the other way round, dear. Listing songs or artists is not enough. Sell the upcoming sequence of three songs now. This is something that I've got a real bugbear about. For years now, we've been sitting there listening to the radio and it's like, yes, it's coming up to 11:32 on Saturday, the 11th of February. And coming up next, we've got Michael Jackson's Thriller, followed by Katy Perry with Roar and ABBA with Take a Chance on Me. They tell you the next three records. Why? Whatever happened to surprises? We like surprises. We don't want to know what's happening next. Oh, I don't like any of those three songs. Switch off. You've contradicted yourself there. Look. Don't warn me. Never tell me the song and artist. What, just the song then? The thought of that particular song may prompt me to switch out. However, once it starts playing, I'm likely to stick with it. You see, someone's done a survey. They've surveyed people, haven't they? That's where they get all this crap from. Listing songs or artists is not enough. Sell the upcoming sequence of three songs. Which one stands out to you? What's great about it? Share those thoughts with the listeners. Be passionate about what you're playing or talking about next. I don't think... How can you be passionate when you've got so many rules and restrictions shoved in your face? How can you possibly be passionate? This is passionate. This is freedom. This is passionate. You are locking people into a small box. Breakfast. Music passion is as important in breakfast as it is in daytime or any other time. Breakfast is our most listened to show. No, really? You've worked that one out. Well done. You got something right on there. It's your job to share your music passion with your audience so that they sample us during the day as well. You're the team captains. Lead the line. This is unbelievable, isn't it? Every presenter, talk about your log. What, really? The one I've just done when I got up in the morning. Is that what you mean? Talk about your log, although you've handpicked it yourself. Now, the log, this is the list of records. Don't think that most radio people choose their own music. That doesn't happen. It's not even chosen by people most of the time. A computer chooses the music. That's how bad it's got. Tony Blackburn doesn't do that. He chooses all his own music. On most commercial radio stations, the presenter is handed the list of records, which has been chosen by a computer. Oh yes, once again, someone has done a survey and selected the best, the most popular records. That's all they're interested in. That's how it's worked. Play every single song, although you've chosen it especially for the listener. You're lying to us then, aren't you? Not only are you coming out with all this crap, you're lying to us. You're pretending that you chose the songs. I don't like being lied to. Love the music. Every song we play is a winner. Be proud of each one and share your passion. The audience will love you for it and listen longer. No, they won't. I won't. Am I not audience? What am I then? Am I not audience? I'm almost ready to swear, boys and girls. I'm almost ready to swear. Mood is the last part of this particular piece of paper that we've managed to get hold of. People, I mean, you see, the thing is, This has been sent clearly by a probably by a by someone who could be a really good radio presenter and host on Bay on one of the Bauer City stations. This has been sent around by someone who is obviously displeased by this. And people have got hold of it. It's not just me that's got hold of it. Loads of people have got hold of this. Mood. People listen to the radio to lift their mood. So have fun. Be positive and enjoy your amazing job playing music for a living. What's the biggest load of crap you've ever seen in your entire life, isn't it? Who wrote that? I tell you who wrote that. Someone who's clearly, is probably not very secure. He or she are probably not very secure, don't feel very secure in their job. And they have to come out with crap like that all the time, you see. Now, do you really think I would fit into something like that? No. No, 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 no. That's why I'm still sitting here, chatting away with all the freedom I could possibly want. You know, I've been on the radio. I've done a little, I did a station. No, it was a large station. I did a large station in London. It was a while ago now, 1999 to 2000. I did the overnight show on Liberty Radio in London, 2 till 6:30 in the morning. Yes, it was overnight, but I had a whale of a time there. I had a list of records. I had a list of songs that were pulled out of the machine. I never pretended that I picked them out. But definitely the song choice was pretty good, actually. And I would fill in with my little bits and pieces. I loved it. It wasn't like that. I mean, why on earth in your right mind would you want to go and work and do that? It's boring. You'd have more fun on the till checkouts in Waitrose. Not so much fun probably in Audi. But certainly if you was on the till in Waitrose, you'd have more fun than if you were working for these donuts. Sticking to that. Awful. Just horrendous. Absolutely horrendous. Anyway, that's the old thing I wanted to read you out there. Okay, boys and girls. Now let's go back to some more of these little messages, which I haven't been reading out, have I? John Child says, very cold here in South London. Oh, I bet it is. It looks cold outside. I'm not going to get to the post office now, am I? You forced me to talk longer than I was going to. Never mind. Well, look, keep warm. Keep warm there. Warren. Incorrect, Warren. I'm not better. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. No, no. Oh, you can stop that now. Stop saying those things. All right, I know my place. My place is in a small room with a webcam in front of me. That is my place in this world. I know that. So please stop bigging me up like that. Gustav says, not Steve Allen, James. Oh, James O'Brien, we've talked about him. So left-wing, dear. I bet he goes to Audi. James O'Brien, you can see him in Audi. And you can see James O'Brien from NBC getting to the till and making some sort of political comment. And that miserable voice of his, God's sake, get him off. Can we have someone more exciting on LBC? Can be left wing, but more exciting than him. Now, who could we have on LBC to replace James O'Brien? I'm trying to think of someone. Who would be good on there? Someone, do you know who I quite like? The bloke on Talk Sport, what's his name? James Galloway, what's his name? Mr. Galloway. Now he's really left wing, but I find him an interesting listen to. Don't you think so? But James Galloway? No, he's the flute bloke, isn't he? I liked him, James Galloway. Who's the bloke? Galloway, can't remember his name. He could be on LBC. Good morning to John Coops. Good morning, John. Hello, sir. let's have a look. Shania's there. Good morning to Leon Corrigan. Hello, Leon. Thanks for your birthday mention. That's okay. Hope you had a nice birthday yesterday, Leon. Can't believe how old we all are now. You're in your 30s now, aren't you? You know? Wow. Poor Vectis only has 10 meg. Is that all you've got, dear? Have you got Virgin on the Isle of Wight? Have you got Virgin? Broadband on there. They are the fastest one. Good morning to Ray Reynolds, who says it's snowing today in Norway. What are you doing over there in Norway? You can't be that far. Warren says he's a Harrods Food boy. Good boy. You stay as long as you want, Warren. In fact, I might even buy you your own internet connection so you can continue to listening. Harrods people are very welcome on this. In fact, I've got the new Harrods catalogue, which has just arrived yesterday morning. Look at that. There's some lovely stuff in here. Oh, wait till you see these handbags, ladies. You ready for this? Ready for this? Look at these handbags. Look at that. I love this handbag. Look at that. I don't have handbags. Do I look like a woman? Do I act like a woman? No, I'm not a woman. But I do like handbags. Look at this. This is beautiful. Gucci handbag. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? If anyone's got time, can you see if you can look that up on Gucci and see how much it is? Because they don't put any prizes in the Harrods catalogue. Look at that. No prices. But there's some other bags in here as well, which I spotted. And I often buy my niece and my sister bags for birthdays and Christmas and things like that. Because apparently, I mean, I bought them both a couple of bags over the years. And then I said to my niece, you know, I don't know what to buy your mum for Christmas. I bought her two bags. She's not going to want another bag. And my niece says, you can never have enough bags. That's what my niece said. So I have continued to buy them. Whether or not I could afford one of these, though, I mean, it is another one. Do you like this? Look at that. Look at the seashells. Now, who's this made by? Louis. Look at that. Do you like that? All the seashells. Isn't that lovely? Who wants one of these? Shania, get your dad to get you one of those for Christmas. That'll empty the old bank account. You'll have to empty a few more bins to get one of those, sir. Oh, we got a call coming in. Good morning. Who's on the line now?
Oh, now, good morning.
Good morning. How are you? Have you gone?
No, dear, I'm here.
Oh, you're there. Who's that?
Hello, Chris. It's Warren.
Oh, hello, Warren. How are you, dear?
Hello, dear. It's been such a long time. I thought I've got to hear your dulcet tones over the airway.
You're not used to calling into programmes, are you, lovey? It's usually texts.
Yeah, it's usually text, bless him, and he always reads them out, doesn't he?
I know he does, yes, yes.
Just like you do.
I try.
No, you're like a carbon copy, Chris. You're like a carbon copy. And I know he listens to you.
He doesn't listen to me. Don't be so stupid. How can you even say that?
No, because I was with him for dinner the other day and I said, listen to this.
No.
And I played it to him. I showed him you. I showed him you. And he loved it. He's going to make a guest appearance. You know, he wants
I
to come
do,
over.
I do not believe you, Warren.
Now, I swear to God, I said, what would you do, Steve, if Chris does in conversation with Steve Allen? The other way round. I think that's what he should do. I think you're going to have to do a half an hour special in conversation with. So you will be interviewing him. You can have sole rights for your station, and I think he should be playing it on LBC.
Oh, there'd be millions.
I think that's the setup of the year. I think we ought to organise it.
Well, if it does happen, what we'll have to do, Summit, is something controversial, so people that complain to the radio authority, they won't be able to do anything about this one, though, because it's an internet show, dear. They could just go off one. That's it, my love. Goodbye. Not interested in your complaints. We're not restricted on this programme, dear.
Brilliant, dear. I think that's a definite, don't you?
You're off your head, you are.
Tenerife. It's Tenerife here, calling, and it's been 29 degrees every day. It's absolutely gorgeous.
How lovely. My mate says I should move out there. There's a radio station over there that always seems to be looking for people, but it's a music station. I think I'd get bored on a music station again.
Oh, you don't do music. You don't do music.
I used to, but do you know how I started? I had a pirate radio station years ago, but then a couple of decades passed, and then this internet station company came up, Live 365. Did you ever hear of those?
Yes, of course.
Live 365. So I was doing a show on there and I realised, it was a music, I'm putting together a little music show and bits in between the records, but I realised, and it was pointed out to me, that the talking between the records was getting longer and longer. And someone said, why don't you do a talk show? And I thought, oh, I can't do a talk show. How can you not have any music to fall back on? Do you know?
Yes.
And I thought, yes. And they said, no, go on, just try it once. I thought, I can't do this. I can't. And then I thought, well, go on, have a go. And I was on CD. There were no, I didn't have MP3s at the time. It was all on CDs. And I literally had to take all the CDs out of the room and put them somewhere else so I wouldn't be tempted to play them. And I did it. And I think it was very clunky. But I did it and I thought, yeah, let's have a go at this. And that's how I started doing this chat business. Yeah, just
well, you're very good. You're very, very good. I think Steve Allen needs to worry. And the other thing is as well,
rubbish. Go on.
Talking about music radio, Chris. There is somebody that is perfect for music radio.
Go on.
Now we've already mentioned him today, and I'd just like to say I think James O'Brien should be on a music radio station.
Yes.
But during his period, he should do back-to-back records. He doesn't need to speak. Nobody actually wants to hear him. He could just place the needle on the groove. That's all he needs to do. And then it'll be perfect.
You know. I don't know. Did you just hear that list of instructions that's come out from Bauer City Radio? Have you heard that?
I did.
Right. Did Steve mention that one at all or not? Has he seen it?
No, he's not seen it, but I tell you what, I think James O'Brien's instructions is just be a prat for the 3 hours you're on, because that's what it would be.
Well, there was an instruction in there that says keep your links no longer than 15 to 20 seconds. For James O'Brien, I think we could stretch to 3 seconds, maybe. That'd just give him time to say Jeremy Corbyn before he moves on to the next track.
Yeah, maybe he could fit in the words Diane Abbott as well in between.
She swore, didn't she? She swore in the House of Lords or whatever it was. House of Commons,
yes.
Did she? She swore. You wouldn't get TM doing that, dear. Mummy Teresa.
No.
Oh, lovely Mummy Teresa.
TM. Our lovely Tia, I love her.
I want fabulous. To find out. I want to find out her shoe size, and I will happily go out and go to my bank account and take £5,000 out and send her a pair of her very own design shoes. I think I need to do that to thank her for looking after us all.
I think you do. I think you do, and I'll join you. So make it $10,000.
Yeah,
any
exactly.
Any more bids?
We like Teresa. We do like her. What a stylish lady she is as well, eh? Don't you think?
I think she's lovely.
Yeah,
I think she's lovely. I think her grandmother must have been Margaret Thatcher.
Do you think that's who it was?
Sure.
What did she do before she was a politician? Do you know? I never looked her up, actually.
I'm not quite sure, but she's from a normal background. She's not specially treated. She's not primed in gold or
well, unlike
or
yourself,
laced,
of course,
laced in diamonds. Unlike us, of course. But she is from a moderate background, and she's been successful. That's what I like. Success.
Success.
That's what it's all about.
Have you got an iPhone 7 by any chance?
I have.
I thought so. Yeah. Yeah, you've only got to move. There's a bit of a problem with these iPhones. I don't know. Anyone who calls me from an iPhone 7, either on my little video thing or on the normal phone, you've only got to move that phone slightly away from your mouth and you disappear.
Oh, no, I'm not disappearing, love. It takes a lot to make me disappear.
It'd take a lot of smoke to send you up in the air. God knows how many matches it'll take when you get cremated, dear.
Oh, God knows, dear. I don't know. If they put me in the same coffin as Steve Allen, they'll never get rid of me. But listen, dear, I thought I'd give you a call from Tenerife just to say hello and also make you aware that Steve Allen does have competition.
He doesn't. Not from me, he doesn't. Listen.
My focus this year. Joking
aside, you need to be pretty intelligent to be on somewhere like that. And you need to know about politics. You need to be able to stand up your side of a phone call when you're doing all the serious stuff. And I honestly couldn't do. I'm not a very intelligent person. You must realise that now by now, Warren.
Well, I've seen you, so yes, I do. But the thing is...
See? There you go, you see?
No, listen, Chris. It just shows, joking apart, you are right. Steve Allen is a star. He's a legend.
Thank you. Yes.
Could you imagine? Could you imagine the skill he's got to do a 2-hour radio station without taking one phone in and not stop talking, and also keep everybody interested? Could you imagine JOB doing that?
No.
JOB has to take calls.
No. I could not imagine that.
2 hours. 2 hours of JOB without a phone call.
Exactly.
Could you imagine?
You've got to be able to do it when you do a show. When you put a show together, you've got to be able to have that show ready. Whether it's, you know, one liners. All I have is one liners. There's just a couple of things written down on a bit of paper. There's a few newspapers. I've got some magazines here. Some little bits and pieces to show people. That's what I've got. I'm ready to do a show without any calls, because it can happen. If you rely on calls, and I've seen this before, in particular on internet radio. You know, you get internet radio stations. You might be lucky and have, I don't know, 10 people listen to a show. That's high figures for an internet show. And of course, you're not going to get them call in. And people, they're like talking, and then they can't do it because there's nothing coming in.
No.
You need to be able to do it without that. And he does it all every 2 hours a day. 2 hours a day.
Every single day.
Yeah.
And he could carry on. And when he does 3 hours, he still carries on.
I know.
He still carries on.
I really miss him overnight. Because I used to, as soon as I would finish work, I'd put him on and all the way home, he'd be chatting away.
Yeah.
And I don't think he took calls overnight either, did he, if I remember rightly?
No.
He didn't,
no,
did he?
Didn't
and he did 5 hours. Was it five? Four hours?
4 hours. 4 hours, yeah, 4 hours.
Yeah, I remember those days were great. I was working at the...
Do you remember those days? John Warrington came on.
Yes.
And, you know,
the travel man.
And Eric Wiltshire. Do you remember Eric Wiltshire? He phoned in the other day to you, didn't he? Yeah.
Yep, RTR,
So all those visitors came on, but he never took calls.
No,
he
never.
He would take calls. I've called him once on his Christmas Day show.
Yeah.
To tell him how to do roast potatoes, dear. I told him how to cook roast potatoes.
He must be able to do roast potatoes.
He does now. He can now.
I tell you where the roast potatoes... Roast potatoes are really nice. Toby Carvery. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, only five quid for a dinner.
I know, love, but you have to get the right one. They're not all the same.
Oh, really?
So, you know, you have to... Oh, no, they're not all the same. You've got some very chavvy ones that I wouldn't touch, you know. The ones with people there that look like they reside there. And
Aldi shoppers.
Yeah, Aldi shoppers, yeah. You don't want to go into Toby Carvery. The worst combination is an Aldi shopper and a Toby Carvery.
Oh, my word, yeah, you're too right. You're not wrong
there. Can you imagine it? It'd be like Brits Abroad.
What about the one in Langley? Have you been there, Langley?
No, not been there. I haven't been there. I've been to the one in Watford.
Oh, yes, I've been to that one. Yeah, it's underneath...
Is the one in Langley okay?
Underneath a hotel, isn't it? The one in Watford? Is it underneath a Premier Inn?
It is, yeah. Yeah,
but I've taken my aunt there a couple of times, and a bloke called Justin. He runs a pub in Hemel Hempstead, the steamcoach, Justin, the steamcoach up there. And the one in Langley, that's all right. Yeah, that's quite near you, isn't it, the one in Langley?
You don't have to keep mentioning James O'Brien. Don't call him a steam coach. It's horrible. I will go to the one in Langley. It's not far from me, as you know. So I will pay a visit. But you've got to be careful. Some of them are not very good. Some of them are not that good. As you said, the one with the Aldi shoppers in.
I particularly like those onions in gravy they do. They do a big
thing. Oh, yeah, lovely.
But they're not. It's not always there, is it? Sometimes they don't have it there, the onions. I don't know why that is.
No, it isn't. But it depends which one you're in, I think.
Oh, right, OK. I've been in the same one a couple of times, and there's one in Frimley. That's all right. That's full of a lot of elderly people go to that one, Frimley.
Yeah, they've got That's fine. That's good. If they Frimley's go there, good. They know. They
so what, what is an example of a chavvy
respect
one?
Respect the elders. Respect the elders.
Yes. Yeah, so where are the chavvy ones that I need to avoid?
In chavvy places.
Where do you live, Warren?
Where do I live? I live in the heights. In the heights of Northwood.
Northwood. I don't even know where that is. Is that Middlesex?
It's near, Middlesex, Harrow, Wembley Way.
Okay.
Sort of, not far from you. Not far from you, love. You're down that A30, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm in Bracknell, Berkshire, yeah.
Yeah, still there on that A30.
I like the A30. I love that A30. Yeah, there's something about that road. It's a lovely road, and you come round past the BP garage on that roundabout. But I get my petrol from the Gulf now because it's always a few pennies cheaper there. You know,
yeah, but yeah. Be careful, because petrol does vary from garage to garage.
Does it?
You've got to stay you've got to stay clear of. I stick to Shell or BP because petrol does vary, and you've got a lot more dirt in the cheaper petrols. So just be careful.
You don't want to get dirt in your eye, do you?
You don't want to get dirt in your fuel system, do you, love?
No, that would be terrible. That really would slow you down.
Right, I'm going to live you, love you, and leave you. I might even give Steve a call now to tell him to catch up.
Oh, no, please don't. No, don't. No, don't ever. Please, don't do that. He needs to sleep, dear. He's got to be sleeping now. I'll tell you what surprises me about him. I do my day a different way round. So when he finishes his show, he starts his day, doesn't he? He doesn't go home to bed.
No, he starts his day.
This is what surprises me about him. So he gets up for his show. I don't know, what time does he get? About 2 in the morning? Does he get up at 2 in the morning?
Yeah, no. He gets up about 11 in the evening, about 11.
11 in the evening.
He gets in about 2. He gets into the studio about 2.
Right, so he goes right round there, and then he finishes his show at...
he finishes at 7.
7. Right, and then he starts doing things, doesn't he?
He gets out of the studio as quick as he can, avoiding JOB, and walks the other way, I think. and then he starts doing things. Yeah.
You see, mine is the other way around. So I come home from work 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. When I was doing that overnight show on Liberty Radio, I would finish there. So my day, it was really packed, my day then. I'd get up. Let me tell you my day. I get up about 11 o'clock in the morning, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'd go swimming. I'd have my lunch, do stuff. Then I'd go back to bed at about 3 o'clock. I'd get up again at 5, if I remember rightly here, and I'd have dinner. I'd have dinner then. I'd then drive to the radio station, which was in Knightsbridge, right opposite Harrods. I'd park right outside the studio. You could park at that time. That was about 8 o'clock at night. I'd record the first hour of the show, right? Then I'd go and DJ somewhere, Black Cap, 10 till 2. The bloke at the radio station at 2 o'clock, actually it was Dave Cash. You know Dave Cash, he died last year.
Yeah.
Do you remember Dave?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
He would then run my tape at 2 o'clock and leave the studio. I would then come from the Black Cap, come through London, get to the studio at about 25 past 2, pull out all the CDs, because there were no MP3s then, back 1999 it was, 2000. Pull out all the CDs, take over at 3 o'clock as if it was like, you know, I'd been there all that time. No one knew. And then at 6 o'clock I'd finish, which was then extended to 6:30, and I'd be straight out the door because you didn't want to get the traffic. It was very, very fine timing. If you left it 10, 20 minutes, you'd be stuck. So at about 6:30, I'd jump back into my car, go straight out of London through Hammersmith, home, and then I'd go to bed, you see, at about...
Yeah.
7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning. That's the difference. He does it. He does his show and then carries on. I don't know how he does that. He's full of energy, isn't he?
Oh, he's full of energy. The thing is, you see, I used to do I did a couple of things with. Do you remember Spectrum Radio?
Jeremy Joseph
did a show on Spectrum Radio.
Yeah.
Do you remember that? I did a couple of, because he was in the night. It was 1 o'clock till 4, I think, Jeremy
Joseph.
That's
right, yes. 1 till 3, I think it was.
Yeah, 1 till 3. And I was on there a couple of times, and I remember the traffic starts at 5 in the bloody morning.
Yeah.
I had to get out and get back. It's
now,
awful.
Where were they?
You're right.
Where
Spectrum Radio was on the North Circular somewhere. I think it was by Brent Cross.
I went up there once.
I can't remember.
I did go up to his studio once, and I was on there with him. Yeah, it was Wembley somewhere. Yeah, it was, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
It was at the back. Yeah. It was like you went round the back and up some stairs, didn't you? It was like a house, if I remember.
Well,
wasn't it on top of houses?
You've never had a problem with going round the back and up the stairs?
Pardon?
What do you mean, dear? You always go in the tradesman's entrance, I heard.
I beg your pardon. I go to the front doors.
Oh, excuse me. Now listen, I'm gonna have to go because I've got a plane to catch. You know,
okay.
Some people have busy lives.
Are you working?
But listen, no, I'm on holiday.
Okay,
I'm on holiday. But listen, I will speak to Steve and I'll get him to do catch up, and he will love it. So, in conversation with, let's make it target for this year. In conversation with.
No, because I wouldn't know what to say. He's a star. I couldn't interview a star, could I?
25 years.
Mind you, I've had Nikki French in here. Nikki French has been in here. She has. Nikki French has been in here. Eurovision hit lady.
Yes, I know.
She's fab, yeah. She is. She came in here and we talked all about her hit. We did. She's
it.
Fab. She's
right,
wonderful.
Love you and leave you. Take
Cheerio.
Care.
Thanks for calling in,
bye,
Warren.
Bye.
Cheerio
bye.
Now. Bye-bye. There we are, Warren calling in. Oh, that was nice to hear him, wasn't it? Wait just a minute. To type something there. What's the time? Oh, gosh, I've been chatting here for an hour and a half today. Let's go back to some of your messages then.
Just
oh, hang on a minute. That's all going wrong now. Hang on, stop that there. Stop. Shut up, Chris. There we are. Some of your messages coming up there. Oh. No, I think I'm up with all the... Am I up with all the messages? Maybe not. Hang on a minute. Am I doing this wrong? It's all going terribly wrong now. One moment, please. Daniel, there we are. Phone line. No, I think we're up with all the messages. Perhaps. Yes, we're up with them all. Good. Okay, all messages done. That's a bit better then, isn't it? Now, we better do today's birthdays, boys and girls. It's birthday time. Today's birthdays coming up right now. If only I can get them up on my screen. How many have we got today? 7 birthdays today. Okay, here we go. To Trudie Jovi Malloy. Happy birthday, Trudie. Many happy returns of the day. Doesn't say how old you are today. To Jhesun Stephen G. Jenna Blazer. 17 years old today. I hope I said your name right there. That's a long name, isn't it? Happy birthday to you. To Scott Brian Whitley. Hello, little Scott. Oh, bless. Happy birthday to you. To Esmee 2, 42 years old today. Tony Beaverhurst Hurst is his birthday. Chris Jepson, photographer to the stars. Chris Jepson, happy birthday to you. And to Mark Thistlewaite, 29 years old today. Happy birthday to you all, gang. Here comes the song. Happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right, happy birthday, boys and girls. Top of the day to you all. Hope you have a nice time. Tonight, incidentally, I've found the messages now. I've got the messages now, so they're coming up again in a moment. If you put a message on there, I'll read those out before we go. Just to let you know, I'm making a rare appearance tonight at the Corner House Bar in Maidenhead. That's tonight, Saturday the 11th of February 2017. I'll be hosting karaoke at the Corner House Bar in Maidenhead, starting at 10 o'clock and finishing at 2 in the morning, OK? The message is then, hello to Keith. Hello, Keith. Keith Hibdl... How do we say your name? Hibdlidge. Hibdidge. Keith Hibdidge says James Whale was a bit obnoxious. I don't know. James Whale, I didn't really listen to him much. I think he's quite talented. James Whale. Now, did I work with him? I think I might have worked with him on Play Radio, which was like an internet station down in the... Oh, it's down the M3 somewhere. I can't remember where it was now. Well, I used to do a little talk. I used to do a talk show on there many, many years ago. And we had that bloke from Magpie was on there as well. He was nice. Keith says, I used to listen to Ian Collins and the Creatures of the Night with Miff Daniels back in the late 90s on TalkSport. Yeah, Marcus Collins is now on LBC. Great show. And he's a really good show. And he's always very much in the middle, you know. He doesn't take one side. I don't feel he takes one side or the other. He's really good, Marcus Collins or Ian Collins. Is it Marcus or Ian? Just a bit. Can I just blow my nose? Oh, excuse me. There we are. Kerry Francis is with us this morning. Kerry says, what's that wallpaper? Ah, that's a material. Have I got any left? No, I threw it away. That's a material, and it covers the whole of the back wall here. And actually, it's a good job I did cover the whole of the back wall, because since we went to the wider camera, you can see it goes right down to the back wall there. So that's a material there, Kerry. All right? Tony Power says, the BBC will soon be having Eurovision live from a phone box. They can't even afford a cup of tea. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're cutting back left, right and centre, aren't they? I don't know why they cut the overnight stuff off on BBC Radio 2 now. Because actually radio is a minuscule amount of money in comparison with what they spend on television. And then they don't seem to continue programmes. They get popular programmes. Dickinson, that's been... Do you remember that excellent, excellent Dickinson series from last year? Do you remember that? That was going to be another series, cancelled. And the excuse is always the same. We want to make room for other programmes. That's the excuse they always use. And there was that Greek mythology programme on Saturday nights that took over from Merlin. They cancelled that. You know, we want to make room for other programmes. They get a popular and then they cancel it. It's madness, madness. Ray Reynolds says, perfect BBC One kill it, picture and lip sync today. Thank you very much. I'm glad we got it all right in the end. It did take some time to get all the camera working and all that. Right, that's it today, boys and girls. Thank you very, very much for tuning in and watching our little show today. All right, once again, tonight I'll be hosting karaoke at the Corner House Bar in Maidenhead between 10 p.m. and 12 and 2 a.m. in the morning, all right? If you're a late night now, I'm not used to working to 2 a.m. I only do it once a week, so I might be, you know, it gets to about 1 o'clock. Slowly falling asleep. And I'll see you again soon. Cheerio now.